Now with the damage here in the metro and to the south, Lindsay Siebert is live in Robbinsdale.
Well, we're going to check in first with Kent Erdahl. He's live at the Faribault Airport. It's been a crazy night in that part of the state. Kent, what do you got for us?
Well, Randy, I don't think I can tell you and quite describe what happened here at the Faribault Airport and without just showing you first, because you frankly can see a lot of it. What's left behind me are hangars here at the airport. We were told that there were several planes damaged or flipped here as well. Of course, power lines down. Crews out here right now trying to secure that after they had to get the road out here cleared. We're right off the county road as cars are passing through, trying to make it through a lot of this damage. Now, we were on a crazy drive all the way from Cannon Falls down here to Faribault tonight, and I can tell you we crossed that path of those storms several times. We were weaving around several large trees. We had down power lines. And along the way, we did catch up with one homeowner who had some help, luckily, just south of Dundas.
We heard I heard my phone go off, tornado warning, and before we know it, trees are falling.
That's Lem Schweitzer. He says after the trees fell on his trailer, he and his girlfriend made it safely on a short run to his father's home just a short distance away. Now, after the storm passed, he had to call his friends to help cut their way out because he said they couldn't even see his driveway.
At least 20 trees that are uprooted in my front yard alone. The windbreak in my backyard, completely gone. Cornfields are flattened.
Luckily right now, we do not have any reports of significant injuries, at least that we know of right now, but that is a big concern. Of course, we on our way down here met several ambulances and fire trucks, people trying to navigate those roads, get to homes, find out what's happening as the night turns into morning. That'll be a big thing to keep an eye on. It's also something that if you're going to be driving, this is an example of what we're finding right here on the side of the road. A lot of dangerous materials, things that could pop tires. It's still very unsafe in some of these rural parts of southern Minnesota. Randy?
All right, thank you, Ken.
Well, flooded roads are such an issue here in the metro that Lindsay Siebert couldn't even get to her live shot location tonight. So Lindsay, where were you trying to go and where are you now?
Yeah, well, we made it. We inched along here, but Julie, this is Highway 100 North here behind me, exiting at 42nd Avenue here in Robbinsdale. This is where we were diverted. We were trying to get to Highway 81 on Highway 100 here, just north of here up the road, but it was closed due to flooding earlier tonight. And we caught all that on the traffic cameras from earlier. It rained so heavily, the storm drains couldn't drain fast enough here on the highway, filling the road like a bathtub, stalling many cars. Now, the State Patrol and police intervened, pushing cars to safety, then closing the road. So that's when we came along trying to get a better view. But along our travels tonight, we also caught some of the same conditions in the area at Winnetka, for example, and New Hope, just showing what cars had to contend with all over the metro tonight. So the roads just opened back up a little while ago around 9:40 p.m. And just before our live shot here, we talked to a Robbinsdale police officer, reserve officer, who told us he personally had to push three cars to safety that were stalled here on the road. And he told us it really took quite a while for all this water to drain here on Highway 100. But back to normal for anyone heading this way.
All
Randy?
Right. Thank you, Lindsay. Jeff will be here watching the weather tonight, and then Sven will take over on Sunrise starting at 4:30. You can also connect with us on Facebook, Twitter, and care11.com.